Now I will explain you the serial control. The way we catalog the book, the same way we need to catalog the serial journals, which we continuously, based on the frequency of the journal, we receive it. There are two things here. One is the vendor, the another one is the item. Item type is the journal in this case. The journal may be the magazine or newspaper or periodicals or anything. We need to establish, in serial control case, we need to remember three important aspects. One is the bib ID, that is a journal. The second one is the vendor. Okay, if you have both, you need to connect this both. The way we are placing the order for the book, the same way for the journal also, you need to connect this one. I will show you first how to create one bibliographic record of the journals, then I will use the existing vendor or I will create the new vendor, then I will start the subscription. After making the subscription, we will start receiving the issues. That we need to plan it. All these three things I will show you. All are in main page only. You click serial. There is called new subscription. Click new subscription. Did you got this one? Add a new subscription. Since you have already created a vendor, what is, you search that vendor, that is Science, Sci-Tech or something? Yeah. Okay. Every one of you got this one? Okay, then select choose. Now I think we have not created any journals. So you can create a record. Click create a record and enter a minimum bibliographical details here. So I will go directly serial 2, which means 245 title. I will all of you type science magazine. Science. Probably you don't need a majority of the details the way you enter for the books.
What we are doing is we are trying to add one serial. When you are doing the subscription of serial, you have to first create the details of that serial in your cataloging record. Okay.
What is happening is, when you are adding any journal subscription in Koha, the title of the journal needs to be available somewhere. Am I right? The title, publisher, when it is published, since when it is published, who is the publisher, year of publication, all these details has to be there somewhere. So for somewhere means you have to have those details in the cataloging area. So what Manju is trying to do is, he is adding one journal title name in your bibliographic data, okay?
Just 245, I enter the title of this magazine, Science. Then you can, if you know the publisher and all those things, immediately you can enter it. Or if you minimum details, if you can carry also. Another important difference between books and serial is that you need to put it in 300, in what is the frequency of this magazine. 310 is the publication frequency. You can see that. You can hear, what is the frequency of those, the magazine, you can define it. Suppose I will put it here, the weekly.
Weekly. Okay, so Science is weekly. You have to enter in $310 A tab, weekly as an option.
Here also, in case if you need the which subject it deals, in 650, that journal, the science magazine subject field, you can enter it, basically it deals with multidisciplinary. You can enter, this is a general science. You can repeat also this one. A again multidisciplinary. I know that who is the publisher. The publisher is AAAS. Okay, this much minimum level I know. Later on we can update it. Item type, instead of book, you need to select serial, the difference. So I will save it. The compulsory minimum fields, you need to select it. Yeah, who is the IT. Yeah. I will go once again to serials. Yeah, at the time of receiving, so you can define where to.
They did not understand. See, we have added the cataloging details, and then you have got the item details page. Do not enter anything there. There you have the barcode option there. So you are not giving any accession number. You have only created a bibliographic entry of a journal which you want to use for renewing your subscription of journals. Okay? So you have to leave it there itself and come back to your serials module.
Okay, since I have already entered this bibliographic details, I will search this science magazine. So what basically I am looking, okay, I am connecting these two records, bibliographical record as well as a vendor, to subscribe this magazine.
Now search for science.
Science. You see that, choose the magazine which I entered, the which library, you can, since we are IITB library we are doing, you can select that which library we are subscribing. Here we can define that, since a weekly magazine is a weekly, you can give a grace period, at least 3 days or 4 days. Okay, after that week you can expect this one. I will give 3 days as a grace period. Pattern notification, location. Yes, as soon as it comes, probably we will put it on display. So I will select the location, serial. I will click in the next now. Number of issue to display to stop. So we can define that how many issue can be shown in the staff interface. Suppose if it is unread, okay, we around 52 yearly we receive it. All the 52 will be a big junk to show the staff. So only latest 4 or 8 can be displayed. So you can define those number of entries here. In both staff interface as well as WAPAC, you can define as much as you put it a minimum here. Then I will click here, I will put 8. The WAPAC, usually user will expect most latest issue of that magazine. So I will put here 4. So then I will click the next. You need to define here the planning. Okay, usually the journal we subscribe for a year, okay, from January to December. We need to define that subscription starting date and the ending date. So when subscription starts January 1st, 2017, frequency, okay, 1 per week. Subscription length, I can define it at 12 months, 52 issues. First issue as well as subscription period, both January 1st and subscription ends with 31st December 2017. Here you can define that which way you want the pattern, like volume number, issue number. I will show you the different numbering pattern. You see that? Usually the volume number and issue, we usually practice this one. Assume that, okay, this is around new volume begin with for 2017 around 152 volume. Since I selected this one volume and number, I will select the volume and number. Let me, volume is 152. The issue I will take it as a January as the issue number, first one. This issue number should be followed by volume number. I will predict this one, how it will look. Click test predict. You see that? Yeah, due to this 12, when more than 52.
Still it is 152 is going on the third. Okay. Every 12 nahi chahiye na hame modify. Every 12 ke baad nahi. Every 52 ke baad hi. Begins with 152, number 1. Add 1 every 52. Okay. Add 1 every 52 issue.
Okay, what the volume?
Now set back nothing, we will do, save as new pattern. New net.txt, save as new pattern. Every 52, that's what I had added.
That we did, na?
One sec, let me see what happens now. Let me see. Okay, now anyway 152 is there. Okay, now yaha pe every 52.
No.
Every 52. Now it is correct.
Monthly.
One, na?
Every month it will not. Every year volume will change.
Now volume, I don't want to change the volume. Now I think it should work. Now I have to add here also.
52.
52.
No. Year. Year 52.
Am I right?
Oh.
Correct? Now correct? Now it is correct. Okay? So anyway, this is how you can
predict
the prediction pattern. So basically that you can and then start receiving the issue.
You see that once you define that frequency and as well as the volume number pattern, so automatically it shows that expected the issues of publications. You can click the receive it. Since it's already, since we are, how many are we are going to receive this one, so as soon as this one, first one, if you receive this one, just you can see that you, whatever you are going to receive that one, you can arrived it, yes, save. That is the one volume one, the issue one 152, I received it. Like that, you can receive the all the 52 issues, or either at a time at the end, or every month you can receive that after week, as soon as week passes. Since here, the disadvantage here is that still it is not connected to accounting. So you can receive only the issues here. You can do the subscription, you can do the receiving that one. Once you receive that, the binding and other things, you can take care of the next stage. Even binding also at currently it is not supporting. For whereas this is for print journal, but whereas e-resources, you need not to do that any prediction. Just if you put a bibliographical details and 856 that URL of that journal, the probably every year you can renew it, compared to the print as well as online. What we did, we created a vendor, we created a subscription, then we received the invoice. These are the three important things in serial control. The only, the major task is that you need to plan it properly. The way, currently which I did something wrong. So if you don't put it properly, that issue number, volume number, pattern and predict, something it will go wrong. Another advantage here in manual system, suppose if you don't receive any particular issue, we supposed to send it manually through, so these are all the issue we have not received, please supply it. But here, whereas if you set a email, after 3 days, I given a grace period 3 days. If I don't receive within a 3 days, automatically mail it will goes to particular supplier. Okay, these are all the following the issue you have not supplied, please supply it. So you can define that note. At the end, after subscription is over, you can create the generate the report here. How many I received, how many I not received, how many I claim, how many late or expected, all the details here. That's all in serial control. So you can practice it monthly and yearly, and also unexpected. You don't know which issue will come in any year, undefined. So within a year 3 may come or 4 may come. Those things also you can select it in a pattern, a frequency. In serial control, do you have any doubts which I have not covered here? Some unexpected issues will come other than in frequency as well as a subscription period. If you compare to the book acquisition, it's very simple. The only you need to select properly that pattern, that's all. Okay? Any queries in any module? Reports, 1, 2, 3 reports. Okay, we will show you 1, 2, 3 reports.
Reports is a very simple module. It just needs you have to select fields which you need and the reports get generated. Koha has a huge reports library. That reports library already has all the reports generated. You have to copy paste, put it into your Koha and reports get generated. But anyway, I will show you one report. It's already 4:10. We can continue, we don't mind. But since we have a limitation of time slot, I will show you the reports, how the reports are generated. Certainly, there are many more modules which we could not cover in the today's workshop, because you need at least 2 days to conduct the workshop and you fully understand, get some confidence, practice, all that is very much important. We have only shown you how exactly each module works. You have to practice and then only you get a confidence on. Let us generate a report. Quickly go to home, click on reports. Okay, as Manju has said, you can generate several reports from each module. Okay. Acquisition module, cataloging module, serial control module, you can generate the reports from. Circulation module, all the modules you can generate the reports from. And there are large number of reports which are available in Koha. So you do not really will not have any doubt that this report I want and it is not available in Koha. There are all kinds of reports available. As I have mentioned in the last talk, at the back end, Koha uses MySQL technology. So what happens in the, whenever you do any data entry, every information that you type in is going to some database, some table and some field. Okay? So all that information is stored in some field of a MySQL database. So what you can do is you can do the permutation and combination of various of those fields and generate the reports. Okay? By default, Koha allow you to, now let me just show you, there is a reports dictionary which is available and which has all the reports available. Right now, we are going to learn how to generate a report that is called as guided reports wizard. So all of you please click on guided reports wizard. Now let us imagine that you want to generate an accession register report. Now how you can generate an accession register report? You have to go to the cataloging and you can generate. Now let us say guided reports wizard, build new. Click on build new. Is there an option build new? All of you could find? Okay. Now it is asking you from which module you want to generate a report. I want to choose catalog. Are you all here? Now next. Okay. Now the report is in the form of tabular, so click on next. Everybody is here? Now you can see on the left hand side there are several fields available here. Okay. As I have said, these are all the fields where you have entered some data. Now it is your choice which fields you want, and then you can generate a report on. Now let us say I want first as an accession number. So accession number is called as barcode. I will say add. Are you all with me? I have selected barcode. Now I want the title of the book. So scroll down until you find title as an option. There is an option here, biblio.title. If you remember, I have been mentioning that every cataloging record in Koha is called as what? Biblio. Okay. So I will say select biblio.title and say add. Done. Now I want author. So author, add. All of you are with me? Now I want name of the publisher and place of publication. Okay. Now where are they? Here is publisher. Yeah. So add publication date, add. Then ISBN, I want add. Okay. So you can go on selecting the fields which you want in your report. All of you have selected these? Everybody is with me? Okay. Those who are with me now, otherwise we will. Now click on next. Have you all clicked on next? Now it is again you are getting one big box by which you can control your report. Imagine that if I have selected a cataloging report and my library has millions of books, my whole report will be huge. So I can restrict my report by item type or by library type, or I can give a barcode range that I want to generate a report on the basis of accession number 1 to 200. I can do that. Or I can add the restriction by date. I can see that whatever books are added today, I can only generate a report of those books. So I can have this filtration criteria. Right now anyway, I am not putting any filtration criteria. Say next. Now it is asking me whether which columns to total. Anyway, I am not saying anything. Say next. Okay. Again, still keep on saying. Now say finish. All of you have done. Now what has happened is, can you see here, you have generated some report and it has written some SQL query. This is called as an SQL query, okay, because it is combining several fields together and generating a report. Okay. Now let's say save. Give this report name as accession register. Fine. Everybody could do that. Now say save this report. Now what you have done in your Koha installation, you have generated first report. That report is from which module? Cataloging module. And this cataloging module report contains accession register details such as barcode, title, author, name of the publisher, place of publication, ISBN number and year. Okay. Now once you have saved this report, you can click on run this report. Are you all here? Everybody? So you can see the number of books which are available in your library, and I have selected the report as a pattern, barcode, title, author, publisher code, publication year and ISBN number. If anywhere I have not entered the data, so somewhere it has, the years have not come, we need to check that. So whatever books are added, all the data will be available to you. Now you can download that report as a CSV file, okay, so that you can play with this book's data and you can customize it, or you can share the details with any library. And this will be available as a Excel sheet for you. Like if you can see here, I can open with my LibreOffice Calc and I can see this as my Excel sheet data. Okay. So this is how you can generate several reports in Koha. And now today there are 3 books. Tomorrow I add some 10 more books. I only have to do what? I have to click on saved reports and then I have to just run this report again. When I click on run, tomorrow whatever books are added, they all will be listed out under my report. Okay. So you have to generate the reports once and then you can run them every frequently. Okay. and there Koha has a reports library. If some reports you do not find, you do not know how to generate them, there is a reports library in Koha. Let me show you Koha report library. That's a wiki page. This Koha reports library, they already have generated all the reports. You have to copy paste that report MySQL statement. See here, huge library. You can think of any report and you can just copy paste this statement in your Koha and you will be able to generate the report. Okay, so report is a very easy module. So anyway, we already have 4:30. We thank you all for paying your attention and we have tried to learn in today's workshop. If you have any queries, we are going to answer the queries. But what we have done today is we have learned how to set up global system preferences, how to use acquisition module, how to use cataloging module, how to use circulation module, how to use serial control module, and how to use reports module. Of course, we could not go into more details because it was for one day. You really cannot learn everything in one day. You need to at least have a practice for 2 or 3 days. But we hope we could make you aware about what are the strengths of Koha. There would certainly be some weaknesses of Koha. And I request you, if you all have any questions, please let us know. Okay? Thank you.